let me welcome everyone back. We ended at this point. Now we are coming to the major part, the solutions. I have prepared some solutions step by step, and then last we'll have a blank slide to cover up all the solutions. And don't worry, all these slides I have already posted on my site, even including this, I'll be putting it. I will be giving at IIT Bombay also. So they will be even putting at their common platform and you can share it. First step, you have already taken it. That was the coordination approach. Step two, we are, as we discussed about the operational manual ready. If you see, as all of you were discussing about different volumes, etc., I have already in my slide, when I prepared this, I was very clear that it should have a different volumes. So volume 1, volume 2, and volume 3. Volume 1 will be the basics, only basics. And volume 1 will be common for everyone. So jaise aapne request kiya tha ki alag hona chahiye. Volume 1, sir, alag ki zarurat hi nahi hai. Volume 1 is common. Because accounts ke principal, chahe Pankaj Goel hai, chahe aap hai, educational hai, IIMS hai, IIT hai, university hai, sabke liye common hai, sir. It never gets changed. But volume 2 I'll be discussing abhi. Volume 2 certainly will be different for everyone. Will be different. And of course, in volume 3. In volume 3, financial statements will be common. Aap ye bhi kar sakte hain ki volume 3 ko you can divide in two parts. In volume 3, A part financial statement, volume 3, B part only the MIS, Management Information System Report. Because at every level I know, your management must be asking different reports. Give me student wise, give me fees wise, give me collection wise, give me area wise, give me course wise. For a particular workshop we do it, give me the revenue. Generally, management institutes conducts MDPs, Management Development Programs. Kitne students aaye, kitna revenue aaya, kitna profit aaya, wo reports. That will be the MIS part. You can see the National Municipal Accounting Manual. I'll give you the link, it's available on the site. That is for municipal bodies, but almost 70% is exactly same. You can download from the site and you can start even reading it if anyone is interested. So, operational manual, as I mentioned, is only the guidance document. It will be a step-by-step solution. And it is never prepared by consultants sitting at the office. It involves major groundwork. They always interact with the sample universities, sample colleges, etc. Then they take the feedback, take the questionnaire ready, and then they involve or include sample transactions. Jaise mujhe bola gaya ek bar, abhi discussion mein, ki sir, next training should be on the job for each and every format, how to record the entry, how to record the asset, perfectly fine. That's the right approach. So when I have suggested the quarterly workshops should be done more on the formats. How to fill the formats. How to pass the entries for the formats. So that each and every step is included in the manual. Manual mein likha hota hai wo. To aapke liye easy hoga. Aap refer kar sakte hain usko. So purpose is only that once this document is there, at least 90 to 95% accounts are uniform or consistent. I will not say 100%. 100% kabhi bhi compare nahi ho sakta. Never. Because everyone has their own platform, way of working. Abhi meri baat hui thi Kashmir mein, to Kashmir mein they are still following the manual accounting. Computers nahi hai wahan par. Very tough. Because I still remember when I started my C article in 97, hardly any computerized accounting. So my boss used to give me trial balance and I used to find out the differences, which was very tough. But now at least once the accounting is through the software, our task become much more easier. So purpose is the operational manual may, like a user guide, it should have it. If anyone is still following cash accounting, then how it can be transferred to double entry and to the accrual base, that step. I'm just giving a rough idea. Actual might be different. Okay, what it should include. This is, if you ask me, it's very, very important. Just tell me, because I was not able to find out in your annual reports. I might be wrong. Anyone, any institute, are they following any charts of accounts or code of accounts?
I am from Biswabharati University.
Sorry?
Biswabharati University, West Bengal.
Okay.
Sir, we are following chart of accounts, code of accounts. Every accounts are coded.
What? Was it from starting, or which was the year in which you started this?
We have our chart of accounts, but last year we have modified it according to the new format. And we have already prepared the chart of accounts.
Are you finding any advantage of the coding?
Yes.
Any advantage you can share with us?
Actually, the classification is very easy. We can find out in which major head it will go, and sub-classification is there.
I am telling you, if anyone is not using code of accounts or chart of accounts, that's the best way to ensure that transactions are not mismatched. Because in charts, I'll be sharing it away. I'll be sharing the structure also. If, let's suppose, you go outside Bombay, and once you go on the street, every street lamp has a number. Even IIT, if I remember correctly, the chair must be having the number. The purpose is, if I take this chair at my home, at least I can pinpoint where that chair has gone. Someone was saying to me that they are mainly getting the funds from the external agencies. It means they are getting funds from, let's say, three sources. Government grants, from external agencies somewhere, and from, let's suppose, direct help. If 5 lakh is the grant I have received from the government, and I have spent that on fees, on assets, then if I use a code as a prefix, I can immediately say, let's suppose here, if I just say I am receiving grant from government and calling it number one, number two, let's suppose, for any external agency, and if I am using this for fees, and let's suppose this code is 20, and I'm using this for assets, and I'm using this code as 30. If I write 120, I write 130. In front of the fees or the asset, immediately I can identify that this fees is from this one. This one will indicate it is from the government. If similarly external, let's say, again 20 fees, and let's say 30 assets. Now if I write 220 and 230, anyone can identify that where you have got the money. Become very easy. The misclassification generally is ignored here. Or yes, starting ki help hoti hai. And codes of accounts is, I am telling you, is a big task. But if it is prepared in 1 month or 2 months, I am telling you, from my experience, your 90% calculations are over. You don't need even any help. You just need an external help for this. If this is prepared, and no external agency can prepare this without your help, you will have to tell it. And these codes of accounts are never exhaustive. Never exhaustive. But it's so important, once these are there, your major task is ready. I'll come to policy later. First, let's discuss about the charts of accounts. It's like this. If I take an example here, in front of you, I've taken one example of your institute. Let's suppose our major code I have taken as receipt. And I have taken number one. And minor code I have taken fees. Fees can be what? Admission fee. In university, the fees can be, let's suppose, college can have undergraduate student fees. They can have a fees from a postgraduate student. They can have a fees from a PhD student. They can have a fees from other than PhD student. I take an example of SRCC. They are running BCom course, Econ's course, MCom, MA Econ's. They are running one diploma course, Global Business Operation, GBO. Different fees. and all will be clubbed under one head, fees. If today your management is interested, or let's go MHRD ask, please tell me how much money you have run, you have got it from your self-sponsored courses. Because all organizations must be running some self-sponsored courses. Once we add everything, it's tough. Otherwise, we'll have to prepare a separate accounts. Is coding a benefit? Kiya, you put a number, immediately filter, okay, Excel mein filter, okay, apne paas aata hai. Excel filtering will help this. You can just add this, gives you figures. Now you can see, if my final code is 1101 or 1102 or 1103, can't I say how much from PhD, how much from undergraduate or postgraduate? This is just one example. You will be surprised, in one of the project, we have also taken up project codes. Because if there are some projects going on, and from that money you have created some assets, if you put a number before that, you can identify this asset was given by whom. In most of the universities, colleges, alumni donates a lot of things. I remember in SRCC, most of the laptops are being given by the alumni. It's a free of cost gift. But some laptops are purchased also. If you do not provide a number, it is very tough. Let's suppose tomorrow an alumni comes and says, please tell me where are my laptops? With whom? How you are maintaining my laptops? Do you want a replacement? If you are not maintaining a proper register with a coding, it's tough. Because anyone can ask, if anyone is giving you a gift, he has a right to ask whether it's properly used or not. If I remember correctly, in most of the universities, colleges, many teachers create funds in the name of their relatives or in their own name as a benevolent fund, as a prize fund. I remember in Khalsa College, one of the botany teachers, his wife expired and she was a botany professor. So he created a FD in the bank of the Khalsa College and said that any interest of out of that FD should be used every year to give the awards to the person who scored highest marks in botany every year as a prize fund. You have received money not from the grants, you have received from the any professor. So that coding will help you. So kindly, if anybody is not following, I'm telling you it's a transitional phase. Go for it. Sir, tally mein bhi hota hai. Tally mein cost centers kit hote hai. In tally, we have done it at the Kabul. In tally, we... Sir, tally may be, if you want, you can create a default cost centers. Sir, ek minute, let's not go in detail. We have done it. I can show the Kabul file to you. We have done it Kabul. It means I am not the IT guy, but there we have taken the help of the IT guy and he has created it. He has even created project codes, location codes, right? Major code, minor code, object code, and detail code. Everything they have done it. I can show the file to you. Sir, there is no minimum digit. If you feel 2 digit is suffice, go for 2 digit. But generally, starting part is 7 to 8 digits. You have to see, please, coding is, there is no minimum digit. Let's suppose today you fix only 2 digit and later you feel more thing has to be added, you'll get stuck. 2 means only up to 99. 01, 02, 03, 110, 99. Let's suppose if more than 99 is available, you get stuck. Go for the higher one. Go for 3 digits. Go for 4 digit. That you have to see it. But guaranteed, sir, aap kisi bhi IT guy se puchhe kar dega wo. If you want, I can just share with you one file. Just see, sir. This is the code which I have just prepared for my project. We are doing a project known as CBUD fund, Capacity Building for Urban Development. Number one, as per the budget, we have two components. Component one and third. There is one component two also for Ministry of Housing, Urban Poverty elevation. That is component two. So whatever budget we get, it is classified in two heads. When I pass the entry, because this work I have to do it as a part of the project, we get under three heads: administration, other charges, professional. It can be easily done. Now it becomes very easy for me. If I just filter the transactions, I get it. You can see whatever fees we are paying, it has three heads: professional fee, out of pocket, service tax. How much for service tax, how much for professional, how much for out of pocket? Because many times you must have seen it, you cleared professional fee, but you stop service tax. Because service tax, generally you clear it when a consultant has deposited that and submitted a challan to you. Then you reimburse it. It means professional fee is cleared, but service tax is hold. How much service tax is payable? It becomes very, very easy. Very, very easy if you have a code of accounts. If anyone is not following, I'm telling you, it's the right way, right starting step. Even in the operational manual, if sir agrees, it can be there. Orange one, major code. Sir, this is not defined anywhere. You can even create lot of heads, lot of separate heads. You take it here. You can create fund-wise, earmark fund, corpus fund, general fund, separate funds, so you can have it. That is fund-based accounting. Sir.
Is there any scientific procedure with you for starting
for coding?
Sir, scientific procedure
scientific procedure.
Sir, there is no science. I am not a science student. I am a commerce student. Science is here.
No, I am not telling science.
I am just kidding it.
any technical procedure?
No, there is no technical procedure. It is a simple logic that you start
suppose,
from.
Suppose receipt, major head is receipt and payment. How I will start the code from receipt and then?
Sir, if you see it here, I have never prepared the accounts of the any education body. Still have prepared from experience, no? I have just read your annual report. Just see. On your receipt
now,
side.
Your code is start with the receipt head, start with one. If I start with two, then what will be the harm?
No easy. No harm. See why I have created one. There's a reason. Why I have created one, as per the government document available, in that coding is this. They use one for receipt, two for expense, three for they use for liability, four for asset.
This is one of the technique.
No, it's not technique.
Yes. It is one of the procedure.
Sir, it is not given.
Yes.
It's not given in an act. Ye to generally follow ho raha hai. Consistency hai. So I followed that one.
There is a specific book, list of major and minor head of the central government. It is.
Sir, but frankly speaking, don't take otherwise. That book is not exhaustive.
Okay, that is not exhaustive, but one can.
It creates lot of loopholes. I'm telling you.
Okay, but one can take the guidance from that.
Sir, if you wanted a guidance, I'll give you a document. Just see in front of you. I'll open it. It is available. You want charts of accounts? Entire chapter is available. This was the exercise done long back in 99. And then after that, state manual prepared. That was the reason when I started my session 2 days earlier, I started with this. It's exactly the same reform which is happening now. You can see it. That's a structure. Just see, sir. You can have a budget center, you can have accounting centers. There is no limit. It's just a structure which has been created, left to the bodies. And you go to the site, you can even find a lot of state manuals. Just see. I was a part of it, so we have prepared this. It's Odisha manual. You can have a state manual also. It's available in the Google. All are available. But this will help you. So this was a major part. If you have not prepared the codes of accounts, kindly get it done. Then the major part, you all have to get agree at least at your level for the uniform accounting policies, I'm telling you. I have already taken the accounting policies. Just remember two parts, true and fair. At least get your accounting policies perfect. Don't even think that whatever we have been doing is right. Kindly refer at least two or three more documents. Kindly refer two or three more organizations. Just see what you can add, what you can delete. This will always, help you to improve. If you think, no, we are, our statements are perfect, we will never be able to achieve the right concept. Accounting policies, agar sahi ho gaya, this just two steps, accounting policies and charts of accounts. If these starting 2 points are right, after that is only a training. Common formats are given to you. Formats are given to you, nothing to be changed. Only charts of accounts and accounting policy. Ye ho gaya, uske baad sirf training chahiye. Only training, nothing else. You all are so expert in accounting, usme dikkat nahi hai. It's just a change in the format. So, accounting policy is a step three. Step four, I was talking about the charts of accounts. I hope you have got the idea about the charts of accounts and the benefit of it. This is the major part. Because when I was reading a lot of annual reports, there was huge comments about the statutory auditor on this. There was no physical verification of the books. There was no physical verification of fixed assets. Fixed asset register was not updated. There are common comments. So it means even there was one more comment that some assets were not recorded, stating that university or the organization has given the clarification that it was gifted to us and we felt gifted assets should not be recorded in the books. That's the reason we have not even recorded it. So that's the reason if you don't record it, then it will not come in the fixed asset register. Guaranteed. So this is the major part. Make sure that you get the asset register ready. I'll come to the remaining slide of the major part covered. That is identification of the assets and the liabilities. If these are ready, then accrual accounting can be easily done. Just pass the entries at the last. Fixed asset register. You can have this classification. You can have the coding in this way. Who owns it? Mere paas clarification aaya tha regarding temporary structures. If let's suppose it doesn't belong to you, then create a separate ownership. It means there will be two codes. For one, you are the owner, for one, you are not the owner. Location, where it lying, because there can be different regions. Where exactly it is lying, uska value kitna hai, uspe kya depreciation rate lagaya aapne. This is, I have just given a sample classification. Sample. You can have even this type of classification. Why I have taken this? It is generally followed in most of the organizations. Most of the government bodies are following this. Property you can divide separate. You can divide land separate and building separate also. Infrastructure asset, I already had a discussion. Agar aap roads bana rahe hain, still remember in Khalsa College they have created a townships. Township for the professors. Logically the roads are there. Usme street lamps lage hue hain. Plant and equipment is a major part. When I was seeing the fix as a schedule, the major items are under this head only. Furniture, fixtures, of course, normal, vehicles. Others can be your books. You can even create a separate head for intangible assets. Sources can be this. You can purchase from your own funds. Then again, a separate coding. It can be gifted. There are a lot of assets which are gifted to you. Agar aapne separate bana, I am telling you, because fixed asset register, trust me, when I was reading, I might be wrong, when fixed asset register, I was reading it, the fixed asset schedule does not classify the funds, the source. It only talks about the assets. You can, please don't even look at the format given by the organization. You can create some separate sub rows or columns. In that fixed asset schedule, just create, these are owned by you. These are not owned by you. These are created from government funds. These are created from external funds. These are gifted. And normal opening balance, addition, gross block, depreciation during the year, and net block. Aapne usi mein sirf ek separate classification kar diya. Wo I'm telling you, trust me, aap hi ko help karega. And if you create a good MIS, wo appreciation upper level pe bhi aati hai. You can create a very, very good pie charts. Ki out of 100% assets, 20% from own funds, 80% from the government funds, etc. And those pie charts you will be able to prepare only when you have the data available. जब डाटा अवेलेबल नहीं होगा बनेगा ही नहीं वो। कौन सा सर? अगर नहीं सर यू कैन क्रिएट वन मोर हेड ना, फंड फंडेड फ्रॉम द एक्सटर्नल एजेंसी। आप सर ये तो सिर्फ आई हैव क्रिएट ए सैंपल, इट्स ओनली सैंपल, इलस्ट्रेटिव है सर ये। यू क्रिएट मोर हेड्स, किसने मना किया? लोकेशन है, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट लोकेशन, लोकेशन कैन बी डिफरेंट। इन IIT इटसेल्फ देयर कैन बी फिजिक्स डिपार्टमेंट, देयर कैन बी केमिस्ट्री डिपार्टमेंट, सेपरेट लोकेशंस यू कैन क्रिएट सेपरेट, व्हाई नॉट। मोस्ट ऑफ द प्रोफेसर्स इन IIT IIMs डू देयर ओन प्रोजेक्ट्स, और स्पेसिफिकली प्रोजेक्ट्स के लिए दे क्रिएट द एसेट्स। UGC ऑलवेज गिव द फंड टू द प्रोफेसर ऑफ द कॉलेजेस, दे डू द प्रोजेक्ट, द एसेट इज क्रिएटेड एंड आफ्टर दैट इट इज ट्रांसफर टू देम, इज ऑलवेज देयर। आई होप यू रिमेंबर दिस मैथड, नाउ इट हैज बीन अलाउड। तो इफ एनी वन वॉन्ट्स टू यूज प्रोडक्शन मैथड, यूनिट मैथड, मैंने कल आपको समझाया था अबाउट द प्रोजेक्टर, प्रिंटर्स, बल्ब्स, प्रोडक्शन यूनिट और मशीन आवर मैथड, नाउ इट्स अलाउड। इट्स वेरी सिंपल कॉन्सेप्ट टू अप्लाई डेप्रिसिएशन, वेरी सिंपल कॉन्सेप्ट। आई टेक अ एग्जाम्पल हाउ टू यूज दिस, इफ एनी वन वॉन्ट टू यूज दिस। Let's suppose I have taken a projector. Because production unit or hourly method are same. And on the box it is written, it can run for 20,000 hours. And when you purchase it, at least you know, because projector whenever it's purchased, you know the estimate use. I am expecting when it will be sold, it will give me, let's say 1,000. And this projector is costing me 31. We use it in our centers. When we purchase it for our classes, we know that it will be used for these many classes, these many number of classes. So if I know in first year I'll be using for 5,000 hours, in second let's say 8,000, and then let's say 7,000. So it means if I want a depreciation for year one, it's very easy, very easy. 5,000 hours out of, simple, into the cost, 31, minus the scrap. That's a depreciation first year. So even, please do not go by the rate. The problem generally, as an accountant, we do it. Even I used to do it, the same mistake. Okay, the rate is given, the base is given, applied at it. You have to see the usage. You have to see the actual usage of that project, that asset. Year two, if I go, very straightforward, 8,000 by 20, same. And the last, simple. You get a depreciation. So these you can use it if you are feeling that rate given in the act is not justifying the usage. You can use it there. I'm not saying always. Use in those cases where you feel that the rates given are not proper. If you remember yesterday when we discussed it, yesterday when we discussed, I have always discussed ki how to find the rate also. Do not go by the rates given exactly. Those are only the illustrative guidelines. If you actually read the schedule of income tax properly, they always say it's an indicative list. Indicative list. No one stops if you apply the higher rate. I'm telling you, if anyone is using income tax rate, kindly devote half day and read section 32 properly. Section 32 mein clearly likha hua hai, a higher rate of depreciation is allowed. Is allowed. No one stops that. These are indicative rates. Section 32, yes, sir. Yes, ma'am, please. Ma'am, that is a revenue expenditure. We have discussed earlier. Frankly speaking, it's very a thin line between revenue and capital, very thin line. The management decides whether it will give the benefit in the future, maintenance expenditure, repair expenditure, are only to maintain the same level. Yes. They are never, never added to the cost.
No, they don't add to the cost, but do they? I think it helps in determining the useful life of the vehicle.
Whenever I'm incurring the maintenance expenditure, right? Yes. That are always taken to the income expenditure. In the useful life, you will only revise the useful life if due to that expenditure, your life is about to increase.
Yes, that's what I'm
saying.
Then,
of course, you will take it. You will also add it to the cost. If you remember yesterday when we took example of computer, there was a computer.
If we want to increase, like say in the northeast, the roads are in difficult terrain, so there was a requirement to raise the depreciation rate for vehicles. So by this calculation, we have arrived at a higher rate.
I agree. I went to see.
Exactly, not to follow ditto the rate of rebate provided in income tax.
Perfectly. I still remember. I went to Sikkim. So Sikkim in Gangtok, now they have a one lane, and logically the roads have been constructed again. So guaranteed, if you are constructed again and it is with a good quality, so logically that is a capitalized expenditure, and you can use it for a estimation of the life. Let's suppose you have only the ground floor earlier. Now you have created two more floors because number of students have increased. So that building life will increase, that building cost will be added. So now depreciation will be charged and revised again. Renovation, if you are adding it, capitalized. But if you are just going to whitewash, it's never added. Normal whitewash of the building is never added to the cost of the asset. Sir, agar first.
संगमरमर का बनाना है
सर वही सिंपल है आप उसको संगमरमर का बना लीजिए वास्तु के हिसाब से बना लीजिए वो स्ट्रक्चरल चेंजेस हैं
तो दैट इज टू बी
नहीं होना चाहिए कैपिटल नहीं होना चाहिए वो सर उससे कोई एफिशिएंसी नहीं बढ़ी वो तो जो पहले फॉरेस्ट था नाउ यू हैव यूज्ड द लेटेस्ट मटेरियल सिंपल है सर आप मेरे से ज्यादा सीनियर यू बनी हो रेवेन्यू कैपिटल एक ऐसा कॉन्सेप्ट है which a management has to decide it. If you feel ki yes, it is a huge expenditure and it will increase the life, add to the capitalization. Accounts mein clearly teen principle likhe hai S10 mein. First, it should increase the life. Second, it should increase the efficiency of the business. Third, management should be able to sell that in the future. If you are able to comply with any of the condition, then capital. अदरवाइज नहीं आपने फर्श लगा दिया फर्श आपको लगता है कि लाइफ इंक्रीज हो रही है एंड फ्यूचर में बिजनेस की एफिशिएंसी बढ़ेगी टेक इट कैपिटलाइज डिफरेंस क्या होता है सर यू नो इट रेवेन्यू एक ईयर में चार्ज हो जाएगा कैपिटल विल बी चार्ज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डेप्रिसिएशन ओवर द ईयर्स दैट्स द डिफरेंस 100 रुपीज आज हो गया या 100 रुपीज 5 ईयर्स में डिफरेंस उसी में होगा बस बट दैट्स द मेजर पार्ट Of course, this we have discussed it, so I won't go in detail. If you remember, there are mainly three types. If you are receiving as a gift, we have discussed at a nominal value. If you are acquired through government grants, we have discussed two approaches, net or gross. I hope yesterday Anand must have taken in detail. But still, before Anand, I have already taken this part in detail. Ki agar gross hoga ya net, your choice. AS-12 permits both. Impairment part, I have discussed it. Do not in your life forget is AS-28. Because this, any time if, let's suppose, there's a fire at any of the building and some of the assets have been destroyed and you are still charging a state land depreciation, then sorry, you're doing a wrong part. You should write off immediately. इसलिए क्लियरली लिखा है AS-28 में राइट डाउन टू द नेट रियलाइजेबल वैल्यू इमीडिएटली रीवैल्यू द एसेट एनीवन आस्क यू द रीजन गिव AS-28 एनी ऑडिटर सेज जस्ट टेल देम गो एंड रीड AS-28 एनी ऑडिटर आई एम टेलिंग यू will get satisfied if you give a reply of the base. When you give, no, no, we have done this because management said, we have done this because we have got approval, no one agrees to that such solutions. So, boliye. Document means, sir?
Then what should be?
Sir, very simple. Ask any, let's suppose this chair, right, is destroyed. No paper available. At least in the market, there are scrap dealers. Scrap dealer will tell you at what price it will be sold.
Item has also been destroyed. Realizable value is also not available.
Zero. It means the entire part is a loss in that year. Now you cannot show that asset in your fixed asset schedule. If that chair has been totally destroyed, document destroyed, then that chair cannot appear in the fixed asset schedule, sir. Cannot. Agar aap abhi bhi is chair ko dikha rahe hain, it means it's like a dead body. You are still showing a dead body as alive.
Point is that the realizable value should be written down from the statement. Then what should be the reason?
Sir, it's very simple. Let's take it here. If in my fixed asset schedule, I was having computer, I was having plant, this is gross block. Let's say 100, let's say 80. Right? Net block. Let's say 60. It means there must be a depreciation of 70 here, 20 here. Now let's suppose this entire computer was destroyed. Entire. So guaranteed, no realizable value in the market. No one will purchase it. Zero value. So my computer will go. I cannot show in my fixed asset now. Now depreciation gets debit. Sir, I hope entry today is right. Thank you, sir. So I am making a full entry. And there will be loss of?
Loss of 30.
Some people directly subtract this 30 to capital fund also. But logically, it should root through income expenditure.
My point is that computer should be on zero value because the value is not there.
The computer zero pe ho gaya, sir. Sir, now.
Computer should be written off.
Sir. Now in the new fixed asset, plant ka gross block 80 rahega, uska depreciation 20 plus during the year ka depreciation aayega, that's a 10. And net block will 50, no computer. Computer you will write discard during the year, this scrap during the year. Chala kya computer sir? Zero ho gaya. Toh sir zero value ho gaya computer ki. Let's suppose yahan par, I am assuming it. Ye pura destroy nahi hota. Value hoti uski. Then logically, if it is at giving you let's say 20 rupees. Abhi bhi market mein 20 rupees hai sir uska. You will still record at 20. It's a very simple logic. So kabhi bhi loss ho, just remember revaluation AS28. I'm not teaching, but otherwise AS28 is huge, huge. I'm just giving you very simple. Any loss where you're feeling that the value has been decreased, immediately use revaluation concept or AS28.
Depreciation 70 rupees is there now. Depreciation 70 rupees is
now.
Provision for depreciation.
Right, sir.
Provision for depreciation is not there. In some organizations, net basis, net assets are there.
Net kalo, sir.
How depreciation is coming?
Sir.
You have to create the provision for depreciation.
Sir, you have to sit with me. I'll tell you the
provision return back the depreciation.
I'll take it. This is gross approach. Yes. If you're not preparing this, then computer will be directly recorded 30. That's a simple entry. AD gets removed from there. If AD is not appearing in the balance sheet, it gets removed. Entry will be directly.
Sir,
AD, you use a different name, AD account provision for depreciation, depreciation fund, all are same. All are paryayavachi or synonyms. Same name. That's a net approach. But why you follow this? Because Companies Act, you guys are using depreciation rate of Companies Act. And Companies Act clearly says use gross approach. That's the reason. And I'm telling you, use gross approach. If you're using net approach, it will not help you. Because net approach make loss hota hai. You are not able to identify the actual cost of the asset. So kindly, if anyone is using net approach, don't use it. Net approach may always is a trouble. At what price the asset was purchased, we can never identify. The actual loss, you are not able to identify. Right, sir? Net approach of AS 12, sir. Depreciation ki baat kar raha hu main. Agar aapne khud asset construct kiya.
So suppose I have made an entry following the net approach. The asset is depicted in the balance sheet at rupee 1. And the liability side also
1 rupee
only. In that situation, if the loss is there.
Simple, that entire loss or profit will become your income of that year or loss of that year.
That's what I'm asking, because amount is not there. It's rupee 1 only.
If you remember, I have discussed yesterday, you keep on preparing your fixed as a schedule. You know the book value at least in the fixed asset. But that book value is not appearing in the balance sheet, sir.
Yes, that's what I'm asking.
That's the reason whatever is the loss at that time is immediately the loss during the year. It means if, let's suppose, this chair is lost, not appearing in the books, you ask anyone, what was my loss? He will say, whatever you have purchased at that time, what was the cost, that was your loss. And frankly speaking, it cannot be your loss because it's not from your pocket.
That is true.
Don't even show it.
So that there is no need to show it.
Just in the notes, I guess.
Yeah, it will come in the notes only.
Simple.
And if it has realization value, something is there, then it will
then
income.
Yeah, cash or debit? Now the major part, please. Sir, this I have just created some topics for the workshops. We can add it also, delete. These are some regional workshop topics I have added. You can create regional workshop accounting standards. We can have a software training separately once it is ready. Or even we can have some 1 or 2 hour session from different vendors. You tell us what are the software available, good software. But there was a discussion during the break that software price should be fixed. Otherwise, the person who has developed the software may try to misuse it. I'll take an example, e-governance is a foundation, NGO foundation of Infosys. They don't even charge a single rupee for the software. They don't even charge a single rupee for the software. It is a developed and they distribute free of cost. In Delhi, they have given to MCD, NDMC, Hyderabad, they have given it. They only charge a cost of the customization, if required. If a management says we don't need any customization, it's fine enough, then no charge. So whenever any software is to be used, what I believe, you correct me where I'm wrong, there should not be any cost because it is being prepared by the ministry and the ministry property. Only for the customization, if required, the charges can be there. Then one national workshop, I'm looking at it, not now, later. When a national workshop only for the formats, and regional workshops can be of the senior people also. And the hand-holding training by IASEI to create accounting cell at the regional level. And whenever any organization writes any query, immediately a reply should be there. These were some discussion which we had in last 2 or 3 days. So when the operational manual is prepared or a training material is prepared, at least a solution to these questions should be there. Which depreciation rate we should follow? This was a common query from everyone. Because please understand, the topic of today's session is transitional issues. I'm talking about the transitional issues. The hiccups, the starting hiccups, you can have it. Which depreciation rate we shall follow? How to deal with government grant if received for depreciable asset? Gross approach or net approach? How to deal with e-books or journals? How to deal with the asset which are created for timing and later being transferred temporary assets? Ye query thi, maine yahan par dal diya. The solution will come from ministry. Treatment of interest if received on 1st April but accrued earlier, sir. Your point. How to deal with this small item as companies that has removed this condition? but your common format is still saying it. Consensus by CNAG on the new format. If we get the approval of the building, let's say aapka point tha, Jamia se. If we get the approval of the building late, then whether it should be fixed asset or CWIP. I know we had discussed it, but still that was a query. And even all of us will agree, there were not more than 20-25 queries. Or in 20-25 queries ka solution dena is not a big task. Agar hum in 20-25 query ka solution de dein, toh I hope journey is smooth. Very easy. Then this is one of the software which is ministry has started. But I know almost it's got more than 1 year ho gaya, and at least I have not received any update status. So is pe kuch hua hai abhi tak? Kaam chal raha hai. Work in progress abhi sir. There were lot of suggestions. Sir, this is the post implementation challenges. Once it is implemented, I'm telling you, MHRD, ICI auditors will expect from you guys transparent financial statements, which are still at present transparent, but transparent means more disclosures as per the new format. And of course, the accounting system needs to be strengthened. This was a query from 2 or 3 organizations. At present, our accounting system needs to be strengthened. Can be due to the training, staff, financial help, resources. Anyway, minimal audit paras and try to have a consistent format for all the institutes. I have some points with me. There was support from the top nodal officers, shortage of staff, weightage given to the professional staff, centralized software, a specific course shall be designed whereby any person who comes for the job at least should go for that course for 2 days or 3 days, maybe through NIFM or anywhere, maybe ICI can do it. A course by ICI, as aapne kaha sir, for accounting standards can be there. That was a proverb, as everyone knows it. So now, after I'm telling you, after this workshop, once you go, you will have a huge task. Your 13, 14 statements are waiting for you, which I know have not been prepared till now. Right? I know it. And of course, a new task. And immediately in July, there will be pressure of the admission. Thank you.